السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد, may the respected brothers and sisters and hands of the Muslim community and everywhere. What can we learn from the pillar of Saai between Safa and Marwa, rushing between Safa and Marwa as one of the pillars of Al-Hajj, one of the pillars of pilgrimage? So many lessons that we can learn beyond that. Number one, at-tawakkul ala Allah, reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like Sayyidah Hajar alayhi salam, at the time of disturbance, trials and tribulation. Imagine Ibrahim alayhi salam was commanded to place his wife and her baby, Ismail alayhi salam, you know, subhanAllah, in the desert without enough food and drink and safety means. And this is a very difficult, you know, situation. But remember Sayyidah Hajar to ask Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, Allahu amaraka bihada fa'uma bi ra'sihi ay na'am. Yes, did Allah ask you to do this? He said yes. قَالَتْ إِذَا لَنْ يُطَيَّعَنَا. He will never abandon us. Allah will never abandon us. SubhanAllah. This is reliance on Allah that we need to create in our life, with our wives, our, you know, sisters, brothers, with our families. Tawakkul Allah at the time of difficulty. This is number one. Number two, Ibrahim alayhi salam has a very good relationship with his wife. Imagine she did not question his action. She did not refute and object and started to fight with him. Why you are doing that? Why you are placing me and, you know, a baby in the desert? But as long as she knows that Ibrahim alayhi salam had done that because of the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, she was in the state of satisfaction and, you know, and tranquility and peace, because she knows that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded Ibrahim alayhi salam. This kind of relationship between Ibrahim and his wife, very needed for the Muslim one, the Muslim community, for our homes, for our families, for our relationship with our wives, with our husbands. SubhanAllah, the kind of trust that Hajar alayhi salam has with Ibrahim alayhi salam is really significant and makes a big difference in the family life and in the life of the children. You know, see Ibrahim, Ismail alayhi salam, when you grow up, look to his obedience to Allah and his father. This is something makes a big difference and change in the life of the family and in the life of the children too. Number three, look at Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam and, you know, the tawakkul ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from Sayyidina Ibrahim himself. And look, Sayyidina Hajar alayhi salam was very qualified to manage the crisis. You know, at the time of troubles, you know, trials and tribulation, she's a lady, but she's working very hard, you know, to manage the crisis. Are our sisters, wives, you know, able to manage the crisis at the time of trials and tribulations? You know, this is exactly something very needed for our sisters and wives at homes. We are in the state of trouble and disturbance. We are in crisis. You have to think how to manage it. You have to learn from Hajar alayhi salam how she was able to manage the crisis and look for, you know, means and solution for, you know, Ismail alayhi salam and the trouble that she was in. This is something needed for our sisters too. This was Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam and Sayyidina Hajar should be the role model for the Muslim Ummah, for our fathers and for our mothers. What can we learn too? We learn from Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam that he was not, you know, a kind of father, you know, when he get emotional, he compromised his religion. No, the Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, he's a father and he's a human being. But subhanAllah, he did not allow his emotion to compromise the religion and the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A lot of people, they compromise their religion because of emotions and feeling and desires. We need to, you know, hold fast in the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we have emotions and desires for so many things in this life at the expense of the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the real test. And Ibrahim alayhi salam is the best one that we can learn from him. Inna Ibrahim kana ummatan qanita lillahi hanifa wa ma kana min al-mushrikeen. Wa laqad awhayna ilayka wa ila alladhina min qablika. ولقد أوحينا إليك ثم أوحينا إليك أن اتبع ملة إبراهيم حنيفا وما كان من المشركين. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and the Muslim community are commanded to learn and to follow the tradition of Ibrahim عليه السلام in his confidence and his trust and his belief and his relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we learn from his tawakkul, from Hajar's tawakkul, from obedience of Ismail alayhi salam, from Hajar and how she managed the crisis, her crisis. Our sister, our wives, they should learn and should have the experience and the enough skills to manage crisis when the husbands are absent. This is something is really needed for our sister, especially in this difficult time. We need sisters, they can, strive hard to maintain peace and life for themselves and for their children at the time of trials and tribulation. And bring up children, very strong children. They believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are obedient to Allah, obedient to their parent, like Ismail alayhi salam. Ya bunayya inni ara fil manami anni adbahuk. فانظر ماذا ترى قال يا أبت فعل ما تؤمر ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين. Do we have this kind of children when they understand the religion, when they understand the importance and significance of believing and fulfilling the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is exactly what we need to learn from As-Sa'i wa As-Safa wa Al-Marwa and these rituals of ritual of Hajj. تقبل الله منا ومنكم صالح أعمال. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.